Hey people, injured here, 2v2, Hydris Chasm, blue side. We have two plague champions. First up is Aspiring Hooper, and we also have Red Beard. These guys start in ranged combat with damage over time bolters, can get melee weapons, some decent utility and support, can build turrets and repair, but is very slow, both using the Death Guard elite scheme, so expect some confusion in team fights if we see any. Red team though, we have Codex as a force commander, very good offense, fights in melee combat, can also tank, disrupt and support with buffs using the Ultramarines DLC from Relic. And rounding off the teams is Toilailee as a Mekboy, teleporting commander that fights range combat, puts out some good damage, can also support, disrupt, build structures and repair. He's a useful little orc over on this east side where this contested VP is up against the plague champion of Redbeard. Bit slow capping, not sure what was going on there. Heretic's now moving to cap that wreck point, and he's going to sit behind cover and outshoot the Storm Boys? Shooter Boys. He doesn't want to move into melee combat here because he doesn't know where the Sluggers are. They could come in and flank at any moment. They're actually over here. Mekboy capping that contested power. Meanwhile, west side, Force Commander chasing down Heretics. He's got two squads to deal with there, and he's cutting it quite close. There's a special attack from Battlecry, but I think he's going to lose the Force Commander. Damage over time from the Plague Champion is doing a lot to help take down that Force Commander. Tactical Marines out of cover, but it will take the heavy cover of those rocks. Scouts also behind the light cover of the vegetation and that little wall. Switch targets to the scouts now that they've exposed themselves. Maybe force melee combat on them, but he wants to not lose a CSM model. If he can help it, the Plague Champion is going to go down, chased by Sluggers into base. Now turrets coming into play, and the CSM should be forcing melee combat on all of this stuff. Here comes some Heretics to help out. They decap the VP. Barrage, there it is. And disruption on both squads. Now he should be able to force off all of this stuff, or at least the double shooters in a way. He's to be careful with these Heretics though, does get them out of there. Now this is 2.4.1, just a few bug fixes on top of 2.4, and expect to see 2.4.2 very, very soon with a few more fixes and tweaks and such. So I don't have many replays to cast right now with all these new versions coming out, just waiting for it to settle down so I get a bunch of replays in. Force Commander taking out some Heretics as they retreat, and they stop for some reason, so annoying, but they get away okay. Now Codex, I've not seen play for a while, but he's come back, just casted a recent game with him I think. He used to use Power Sword and Armor of Alacrity a hell of a lot with his Force Commander. Going for some Assault Marines over on the east side, which is blue. We have Storm Boys maybe seeing the grenade launcher Heretics made him get those Storm Boys up quickly, since he doesn't have to contend with Doomblast though. The Plague Champion, oh, he's gone for the sword immediately. He can deal with melee pretty damn well in all tiers. Power Bash here. And the east side is completely capped up by Toilailee, those contested points all the way on the edge. Can they hold their natural? He's retaking it, is Aspiring Hooper, backing away from the Assault Marines. Now he needs a plan to deal with them. You cannot let the Assault Marines run riot in Tier 1. They put you under so much pressure. He's got to respond with a Plague Sword, I think. Does he have the resources to do so right now? He does. Not doing it. Oh, he's getting Aspiring Champion for Heretics. He might go double Aspiring Champions. Oh, he can't. Well, he can, but he's got grenade launchers on one of them. Is that all he's doing? I would get the sword as well. Get the sword and the Aspiring Champion for your Heretics. They are getting flamed up by those Tactical Marines. That was a Doom Blast, which suppressed the Assault Marines into a hole or else, and he's forced off there. Good push from Codex. Level 2 Force Commander now. Actually got a Chaos Space Marine as well. Yes, he did. And now he's going to bash power with a flame and a whole bunch of other stuff. This is not only hurting the economy of the blue team, it's also giving XP to all of that stuff that bashes. 460, 498. Orc is forced off on the east side, and Redbeard can retake the VP at least, and he's got Heretics capping up these points, or at least trying to. Now he's going to try and bash with double CSM. One of them has dropped a model. He's got those grenade launchers as well. And in terms of his Plague Champion, Plague Sword and Mucus Discharge. So he's just going to try and focus fire those Storm Boys, I think. He doesn't have fetid armor to suppress them. That was the Mucus Discharge heal. Look at the damage on those Storm Boys. Gets a zombie one, but there is the battery pack heal. Have a taste from the Mekboy. Slugger's now moving in though, backing up that jump and almost took out the CSM. Plague Champion is done for. Can he get a model before he goes down? No, he can't. 457480. I really would have got fetid up as well if I was Redbeard. Maybe he wants to save his resources. It's so cheap though, just 120 for that armor. It's really good as well. I love Unholy Stench. Both Plague Champions then with the Plague Swords. And both of Mucus Discharge. 457-472. Codex, the first player to go tier 2. Kept his power very safe so far. Lots of Daka. We have the big shooters up. Oh, touch of Nurgle. Now, quite a bit less effective on Heretics, but they're still doing a good job of it, as you can see. Still very effective on them, all because they can use that Doomblast to trigger explosions and suppress and do extra damage from the Doomblast itself. 448-472. Blue team will retake the contested VP, it looks like. Here comes Storm Boys for another round of chopping. He's coming to revive. Here he comes. Is it going to mean... I'm not sure if that's going to be enough to level the Plague Champion. It might not. But he's going to be very close to level 3 if it doesn't. Toilailee now goes tier 2 as well. Yeah, not quite enough to level him. And blue team behind on tech got both powers bashed. This one only has one generator as well. But now they're going for a 2v1 fight. Can they do a lot of damage to the Mekboy's army here? Storm Boy's getting away thanks to a heal from the Mekboy. It's 150 heal, I think. Yep. Which is big for relatively squishy tier 1 orc squads. Heals them up to full pretty much usually. But they're getting a power bash at least. They're turning the 2-1 into a power bash. If not tons of losses. He lost a bunch of shooter boys, kept them in play a little bit too long. Should never have let those heretics get into Doomblast range. 439-2472. Some Nurgle worship. The power is going to be completely bashed, but look at this. Codex has taken the opportunity to decap and take the VP and decap the power there. Here comes some heretics with a Doomblast. Is he going to touch of Nurgle them? Has the red frit, but decides not to. 426-472, the 2-1 for the red team in effect still, and a dreadnought for Codex. He's gonna need to respond with Havocs, you would think, and try and keep the assault marines off them. Plague Champion flying into combat, takes out a tactical marine, gets a tactical marine zombie, but then immediately goes down. Was a bit too far ahead of his army there, the Plague Champion. Now the zombie explodes, some Nurgle worship, but the Plague Champion will be revived by Aspiring Pooper. Oh, that was Redbeard's Plague Champion. Didn't I tell you I was going to get confused? He's a Death Dread. But he's not engaging, what's he doing? Oh, he's coming, there he goes. Oh, look at the Stormboy knob with a huge chopper, or what it's called. Those big two-handed axe things that the Orks use. Are they chain axes? I think they are. Here it comes. Much more fitting for a heavy melee weapon. No, it's not a chain axe. It's some weird spiky axe. That looks awesome. So he no longer has his pretty useless sidearm, but now he has a big choppy axe. Heavy melee damage. So big damage per swing, but he's going to swing less, which in general is what you want. Especially on stuff like early vehicles, getting those rear armor hits. Big rear armor hits can really make a big difference. 339-472, triple cap for red team. Blue team in a little bit of disarray. Look at the map, it's very, very red. Can they recover here? Plague Marines for both of the Plague Champions. these guys getting some extra health regeneration and some extra damage with their bolters, piercing damage that is, so a little bit more effective versus infantry. A single Plague Marine, probably not enough to deal with a Dreadnought, but he's got two shots off. He's not turning into a Gator, he's going to get another. He needs to keep the Plague Marines moving forward manually. 286, 472, so that whenever the cooldown is complete, I can get another shot off like that. He's got half the health off this Dreadnought. Meanwhile, Chaos Space Marines, out of sheer anger, having to melee the node back down to recapture it. Scouts with shotgun and Sergeant. Plague Champion getting absolutely shot to pieces by Shooter Boys. Gets away just about. Stick Bombs almost finish him off. Goes down to about 5 hit points. Oh, Noxious Cloud though. And yeah, if you don't spot it, that's what happens. Moves very slowly though, so once you do spot it, you're usually going to get away. Did a lot of damage there though with it. Sluggers catching up to double CSM, and they're leading them into this Chaos Space Marine rear line. Is he going to force melee combat? No, he could have finished him off there. What's he doing? That's a massive misplay. Led them back into trouble, so he should have just forced them melee combat on them. Would have finished them off. Spashing power. Spiring Hooper taking his power back. And here comes the Plague Champion, who's level 4 and he's gone for Armor of Pestilence. So he's up to 1457 hit points, level 4. Scouts infiltrating, they have their elite training or whatever it's called. Chaos Space Marines with Aspiring Champion, so they can use Slaughter once it comes off cooldown, that is. Got some nerfs for 2.4. Full retreat here from Redbeard, and he's going to lose the VP and still has no gens here. They are hurting for power, the blue team. Double Plague Marines here for Redbeard. You'd hope he could deal with a Death Dread with double Plague Marines, but you never know. They get tied up like this quickly enough. Headbutt there from the Knob Leader. He's very pleased that he has this massive axe. Long overdue, I think. It was kind of silly for him to have that heavy melee knife, especially for new players who don't know what the decorators mean and think he's got a heavy melee knife, and they're superbly confused when he starts destroying your Razorback with it. Oh, there's the Cult of Speed, I think it was, Speed Cult or whatever it's called, buff on the Dreadnought from the Mekboy. That's one of his global buffs, increasing the speed of vehicles and I think decreasing their weapon cooldown. 251, 2452, so 2-1 for Red Team. They have dominated so far, it's got to be said. Tier 3 for Toilailee now. Blue Team still have solid armies, they've not lost stuff, they've just been outmaneuvered and haven't responded quickly enough to threats. The Dreadnought wasn't dealt with, the Assault Marines of Codex were not dealt with quickly enough, I think. Plague Champion is revived again. So much XP from reviving. It's Brian Hooper's Plague Champion is now level 5. 205, 452. Can he get these Storm Boys into the back lines and tie up those double Plague Marines quickly? Does he even want to do that with the Plague Champion there? Does not have burners and bits for the Death Tread. So that's a very cheap Hawker. That's causing a lot of problems for Redbeard. He's got double Plague Marines to deal with it. There's a jump from the Storm Boys. They will stun on land thanks to the big fat Storm Boy Knob going straight after the Plague Champion here, and they're forced off immediately. Here come Aspiring Champion Heretics for Hooper, supporting the east side now. It's a 2-1 fight versus Toilailee. Very quick assist from Hooper. Codex was off the field, so he thought, hey, let's go and assist. Some Nurgle worship. Plague Champion of Redbeard, still level, just level 2. Look at this, they pushed back the east side completely. Can they cap up all this stuff, get some resources going? Raptors on the way for Redbeard. Wants to stop those Shooter Boys pouring on so much DPS, I think. Tier 3 also for Codex. who's pushing the west side again, decapping the VP and the rec point and the power. Very slow to respond was Hooper. He should have turned around as soon as he forced off Toilailee, I think. What are these guys going? Go for a power bash, red beard. He's got a double plague marines there. He's going to get at least one generator, you would think. Might get two. Stick bomb thrown in. Yeah, he's going to get two generators. There we go. He might get three. 168444 gets almost a full power bash very quickly there. Dreadnought has found a plague champion to smack around. Almost level two, this thing. Raptors jumping in. From Redbeard coming over to the west side and getting absolutely wrecked. Jumped near a melee Dreadnought. Not a good idea. And this could be really bad for Redbeard. He's got pincered between Toilailee and Codex. Should get away okay. Doomblast helping out somewhat. Special attack from the aspiring champion there. And they do get away. Everything gets away. And east side is looking very blue right now. And they're taking the power even. Very strange game in terms of assists and stuff. Players getting dragged all over the place. Toilailee, does he have anything out in tier 3? I don't think he does. He's been reinforcing a lot. Play champion. Level 5 still from Aspiring Hooper. He's almost level 6. 1496 hit points with that Armor of Pestilence. Fetid is on Redbeard's play champion though. Knob Squad, he did get a tier 3 thing up. Wow. What the heck happened to the Knob Squad? Was that all the Plague Champion? Maybe he caught them running and not engaging. A lot of damage done to that Knob Squad there. Unupgraded at the moment, but still. 112444 is a 2-turn cap for the red team. Blue team have a huge amount of VPs to make up. I'm sure they'd love a tank right now. Aspiring Hooper does go tier 3. Mina and Green are on the way for that Knob Squad. Stick Bomber. Zombie. Plague Champion doing really well. He announces the Knob Squad. Does Red Beard, so he might get Marcus Inc. CSMs. No sign of it yet. Doesn't have the resources to get it, I suppose. Yeah, doesn't have the rec. He gets a Shriner. That will suppress the Knobs. Then they'll pop Frenzy, I guess. It will keep the Storm Boys suppressed as well. But here comes a big 2v2 fight because Codex is joining in over here. Assault Cannon now up for the Dreadnought. Tried the barrage there just to keep those Plague Marines disrupted. And now these Storm Boys are going into melee, but the Plague Marines are exploding their filthy crap all over them. Some Nurgle Worship and Chosen Plague Marines on the field for Aspiring Hooper. These guys now have melee resist and some extra health regen. They are going to be a real pain in the ass for melee squads. 106410. Not that they weren't already, but with melee resist, they're going to be even more so. Look at the damage they're doing to those Vanguard veterans. With some help. Vanguard veterans jumping away and then retreating, I think. Nope, just running out. Good engagement for blue team. Really good engagement. Kept really solid there. There's the durability of the Plague Champion's armies for you. Nurgle Worship. Bunch of Plague Marines all over the place. It's hard to dislodge that. Not to mention leveled up CSM. Look, we've got level 3 CSM for Redbeard. 1663 hit points. Some level 2 CSM with Marco Zinch now. That's a good choice. When you're fighting Knobs and a bunch of Space Marines, get your Mark of Zinch action going. Maybe even Mark of Corn on one of them. With Plague Champion support, Mucus Discharge, they might do well. Where is Redbeard's Plague Champion? Down, up here. I'm sure he's going for the revive. We'll see if he can get it. Another Shrine goes up, and another Shrine goes up. Some cool play from the blue team, trying to stand firm in the middle. Is Codex going to go for a decap with his scouts on the VP? You'd think he would, but no, he's coming mid with them. He's coming mid. Has a lot of resources. Is he saving for a land raider? I assume he is, unless he's dropping Terminators this engagement. 106, 362. Stormboy is initiating. It's a lot of stuff to jump into, a hell of a lot of stuff. Raptors with Aspiring Champion jumping ahead. The Shooter Boy is already forced off, so they're out of the engagement immediately. And I think Toilailee engaged a little bit too quickly there. Let's have a look at his engagement. Vanguard Veterans happy to fight the Chosen Plague Marines, it seems. There's the Merciless Strike hit. So much stuff, but all of that stuff is so tough, it barely did anything to it. Vanguard Veterans getting torn to shreds there. Oh, look. Zombie Vanguard Veteran with a hammer. That's awesome. And down goes a Dreadnought. Yeah. Codex should have gone down the west side, I think, and try and split this massive Nurgle force. It was a mistake to try and fight it head on. He did drop Assault Terminators, though. Look at this. Didn't even realize, and they're almost dead already. Getting chased by Raptors. Aspiring Trooper, Aspiring Hooper getting into character a little bit. Can they finish off these guys? Stormboy's trying to save them with a stun jump thing. And the Assault Terminators live. Those guys now have a bit more damage on those Thunder Hammers. But surely he's going to go for Lightning Claws and try and shred through all this stuff. More Plague Marines for Aspiring Hooper. And why not? Look at this comeback. 106-308. It was a big mistake, I think, for Codex not to push the west side. They failed in the big team fight there. Toilailee also went in a little bit too early with his stuff. And trying to initiate with Stormboys against so much is, I think, not going to work out too great for you. Wait for Codex to initiate instead with his much more tough Vanguard Veterans. At level 2 now, almost 2,000 hit points. That Nurgle Worship again. Vanguard Veterans are going to go down here, I think. Chosen Plague Marines, I should say, on retreat. Yeah, down they go. Bad engagement for Codex. And you see the Nurgle's Rot ability from the Chosen Plague Marines creating zombies on death. And a Noxious Cloud for good measure. So much Nurgly goodness. How does Codex recover here? I don't think he wants a tank because of the Plague Marines floating around all over the place and heavy melee Raptors. Well, the Aspiring Champion's got a Plague Power Fist anyway. I would have gone for the Land Raider and not the Terminators, but he still has them. But they're not reinforced, so they're not going to be taking part in any engagements anytime soon. Looted tank on the way for Toilailee. I think it might just be shot down quite quickly. Nog squad moving up, maybe get a bunch of flash gates going. Stick bombs thrown in. There's another shrine. How many do they have up now? They're down to the two, one on each side of the map basically. You see it suppressing that stuff there. Being flamed down though. They still holding on to this 2-1. Blue team pushing hard now on the west side. Does Aspiring Hooper have help? Looks like he does. And look at this. Pestilent, the Plague Fist, I should say, on the Aspiring Hooper. Level 7. There's Pestilent Strike. And here's the flank from Redbeard. This could be really nasty. Massive team fight again. Down go Heretics, completely wiped there, I think, thanks to Nobs. And Chosen Plague Marines, just as too much melee for them to deal with. Raptors are going to wipe. Decent engagement for Red Team. Look at all the zombies being created. Stuff leveling up left and right. The Knobs level there. They're level 3 now. Wow, I thought that was going to be really bad with that flank coming in, but they did quite well. But that's a Noxious Cloud, and that is nasty. That is pretty nasty. Retreats out. Knob squad fully upgraded at level 3. That is going to be painful. And the Force Gunner now has the Thunder Hammer. So he can keep things disrupted and teleport back to initiate. Plasma Cannon. Misfires. But there's Veil of Time. Do we have Marco Zinch for Aspiring Hooper? Yes, we do. Redbeard lost a bunch of stuff in that engagement. Lost his Raptors. Lost his Aspiring Champion Heretics. And I think something else. Level 4 CSM here. Red team recovering now. 106, 183. They still need to take that east side back. He needs to get the unnatural power. What does he have here? Shooter boys that are not reinforced. Storm boys, looks like they lost their knob leader. That's painful. Repurchased that. At level 3, those guys. And it's the librarian who's decapping. And a good place for a plasma cannon overshoots it. Looted tank needs to be very, very careful indeed. Chosen Plague Marines are pretty damn good versus single targets because the damage over time of their knives stacks up a hell of a lot. I think indefinitely now. Although, obviously, it has a duration. Yeah, Chosen Plague Marines don't really want to take on Terminators, I don't think. He put Touch of Nurgle on them as well, but retreated them out. They didn't lose a model. Is that the super tough beam from the Mekboy on those Storm Boys? Yes, it is. 75% damage resistance, huge amount, and immune to knockback and suppression. Is that the best buff in the game? It must be. That is an insane buff. 106, 143. How long does it last? Does it tell me here? No, it does not. Probably tells you on the ability itself. I'm guessing it's 10 seconds though. Engagement here outside Redbeard's base, or Aspiring Hooper's base. Plague Marines in retreat. Those are Redbeards. Red team recovering well, and they're focusing on this west side to try and get the two VPs for the win. And they have them. There's the 2-1 again. 95-143. Chaos Predator on the way for Redbeard. Wow, I definitely thought the red team were out of it. More Noxious Cloud action. Seen tons of those. Look at the Marquezine CSM pouring those Inferno Bolts onto those Assault Terminators, but they do not lose a model here. Plague Champion taking his natural VP back over there. And Scout suppressed by the Shrine. It doesn't actually deal any damage, so they're not too bothered. And they're going to cap the VP for what I assume is going to be a 2-1. There it is. 68-143. Can the red team hold on to this VP advantage and see this out? One bad engagement could turn it, just as it did for Redbeard, where he lost a bunch of stuff there. That's the thing about Dawn of War 2. When you're behind and you've still got decent armies on the field, keep on fighting, because one good engagement can completely turn it around. It's a 1-1 cap. West side, blue team pushing it hard, got the decap on the VP, but the Thunderhammer Force Squadron there having words forced into retreat there. Plasma Cannon getting shots, does not take out that retreating CSM though. Needs to do something about that thing. That's a zombie librarian. I was going to say, what the hell was that? Replaces the librarian now, Codex. He definitely wants that Veil of Time, and I'm sure Gate of Infinity for those Assault Terminators. Plasma Cannon loses a model, and blue team take the west side up. 55-140, but here come some sneaky scouts. Level 4 sneaky scouts. What's going on east side? Tank does not last long. Great unclean one on the way for Aspiring Hooper. That's going to be so fun to see. Codex has tons of ready. Could drop a really telling nuke here to stop a cap or something. Toilailee also has tons of resources. I'm sure he wants a battle wagon right now. Battle wagon and a rock soon-ish. Well, 360 red, but Orks can get red very, very quickly. Though they also spend it very, very quickly. 55-135. Pestilent Strike trying to save the Plague Marines, and it does. Look at that health regen. Oh, they still lost the model. The heck? Must have been a delayed attack animation after the... Yeah, they started an attack animation, and then he stunned the model that started it, and then the stun wore off, so the animation played out, as it were. Oh, a tank shot? Maybe it was just a tank shot. Maybe I'm overthinking it. Either way, they are gone. Yeah, I didn't think it was a tank. I think it was just a delayed animation. Redbeard down to two squads. Toilailee surely is going to be dominating that east side now. The knobs are just too much for Redbeard to deal with if he doesn't have an army. Orbital catches some stuff pretty well. Where's the third beam? Did he put two of them in the same place? He must have. Smack. Smack. Yeah, the other one's there. Some friendly fire on the Assault Terminators. That did tons of damage. Holy crap. Great and clean one with his Nurgle vomit stuff. And he took out a model there as well with a hit. 55-117. Another looted tank for Toilailee, not the battle wagon. Librarian is going to go down here, I think. Yes, sink kill. Just swats him aside, the great unclean one. Aspiring Hooper is still very strong on this side. Redbeard should just come here, try and reinforce him and keep the pressure on his VP, maybe. Just keep something on the east side to try and ninja cap that VP over there. Now he's have to fight 2-1 though. Aspiring Hooper. There's tons of power. Redbeard down to a single squad now. GG, there's a double cap for Red Team. Looks like they are going to take this game. Might even get a cheeky triple. CSM moving into force melee combat. Are they? What are they up to? No, just getting very close to shoot the scouts. There's a triple cap and Red Team are going to take this. It looks like great back and forth battle. Some amazing and very, very fun team fights. I think that bad engagement for Redbeard was a turning point where he lost his Raptors and his Heretics. He never quite recovered from that. And there you have it. Let's look at the commanders end of the game. Plague Champion level 10 for Aspiring Hooper. Redbeard's was level 4 and down. Lots of the XP from just reviving the other guy. Level 7 Force Commander had Thunderhammer, Artificer, and Teleporter Pack. Very popular build for the Force Commander. And Mekboy, level 9 with the Battery Pack and the Super Tough Beam. Look at that buff that it gives you. That is nuts. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time.